Okay, so we talked a little bit about adiabatic cooling. So let's kind of, and humidity, let's put some of these ideas together. As air rises, it cools because of adiabatic cooling, it gets colder. We learned when we talked about humidity that cold air can hold less water than warm air can. Cold air is not as capable of holding air as warm air is. So as air rises, it gets colder and wetter. So what happens when the air reaches the dew point? It gets cold enough that it reaches that dew point temperature. It becomes saturated. At that point, the relative humidity is at 100%. So saturation is when it reaches that point. So the short of this is, the primary way that condensation is brought about in nature is by moving the air upward and cooling it down. So these are something called atmospheric lifting mechanisms. And it's different ways that air is moved upward. But the thing I want you to take note of is, what do all four of these diagrams have in common? All four of them are showing the air being pushed upward. As it's pushed upward, it cools adiabatically. As it cools adiabatically, the relative humidity will go up, the air will become saturated, and condensation occurs. So the main way to go about bringing condensation or precipitation in nature is by moving air upward. And there's four principal means of doing that. We call those atmospheric lifting mechanisms. So I'm going to go through these one by one. One is convergent lifting. And that's what happens at places like the intertropical convergence zone. Place the low pressure belts of the Earth on a global scale. Air is coming together and being pushed together and then being pushed upward in a low pressure zone. So where we have these belts, these pressure belts, these kind of loops, where we have places like the polar front and the intertropical convergence zone, here we have low pressure air is being moved upward because of that cycle of air moving. A second way is called convectional lifting, that you can have circumstance, and this is about the differences between land and water, where air can, moist air can come over the ocean and then be over land that is much warmer, and the warmer land can cause the air to convect, warm up and move upward. It's called convection lifting, like a convection oven. Same principle like a hot air balloon, you heat up the air rises. So for example, here with the state of Florida, you have all these clouds that are happening because moist air is moving over the state of Florida. Because the land is warmer than the ocean, it's causing that moist air to heat up and rise and heat by convection. A third way is orographic lifting. And this has to do with what we called the windward and leeward side of mountain ranges earlier. When air is pushed over a physical barrier like a mountain range, that's called orographic lifting. Sometimes it's also called the type of precipitation, like this would be orographic precipitation, for example. This is when air is forced over a landmass such as a mountain range. So here we have, you know, air is moving in a certain direction because, say, the westerlies or the trade winds, they encounter a mountain range like the Sierra Nevada or the Andes Mountains. As they do, they're forced upward, and that upward movement of the air creates condensation and precipitation. Conversely, on the other side where the air is moving downward, it's heating up and then becoming drier. So if you look at California, the Sierra Nevada, the windward side, because of the westerlies coming in, is quite wet, like in Yosemite National Park, let's say. But on the other side in Nevada and some parts of the California desert, you're on what they call the leeward side, where the air is moving downward and it's quite dry. So I do want you to, we've noted them before, I do want you to know those terms. You have the windward side, the side of the mountain that the wind is coming from. So in the case of the Sierra Nevada, the winds are coming from the Pacific Ocean and then blowing up on the windward side. those winds are then blowing downward on the leeward side. And another term for the leeward side is called the rain shadow. The rain shadow is the dry leeward side of the mountain range. The fourth and last mechanism is called frontal lifting, what we call cold fronts and warm fronts. We're going to be discussing those more in a future module, but essentially this is where masses of cold and warm air come into contact with each other. And in each case, the warm air is pushed over the cold air. This is called frontal lifting. So two examples, you can have a warm front where warm air intrudes to an area of cold air and it glides gently over the cold air. This is more common what we see in Fresno, where we see long cloudy skies. And then also we can have cold fronts. This is where cold air moves in and rapidly forces the warm air upward. This is less common in Fresno, more common in the Midwest. We'll cover this more in the future. So just to recap, we have four different lifting mechanisms. We have convergent lifting, like at the intertropical convergence zone, convectional lifting caused by heating of the air, orographic lifting, where it's forced over a mountain range like or other type of a landmass, and frontal lifting, which is caused by the clashes of cold and warm air.